Then there is some specific, then peculiar property of this pith plus. The scientific name is Pleurota sajor kaju. And this belongs to that Basidiomycetes fungal group, where it is capable for detoxifying the phenolics and producing biopolymerizing enzymes. As we know, coir pith basically it contains around that 30% of lignin, 26% of that cellulose. And apart from this, there are so many that micro elements, trace elements, etc. So what the lignin present in the coir pith needs to be degraded. Otherwise, it will be that accumulate in the environment, causing that because it is a recalcitrant. So this organism, by applying over the coir pith, it start to degrade the coir pith, and we are putting or we are adding some that nitrogen supplements, either urea or any natural supplements. In the conventional way, that normally we are adding urea at 0.5% basis, but in the new method, some natural supplements available in the as a resource material in nature, that can be supplemented as a substitute to urea for composting of a coir pith. So this is the conventional that process of the coir pith organic manure production. Here that CPO, that is the coir pith organic manure. Then when it's just first you have to select an area that 5 into 3 meter length, 5 meter length and 3 meter width, that in 15 square meter area you have to select. Then spread 100 kg of coir pith over that column. 100 kg means around that normal 4 to 5 that kutta or something that you can use, or vessels you can use. That vessels, when you spread that 5 buckets or 5 that vessels, it will approximately around that 100 kg. So the first layer, 100 kg of coir pith you have to spread over that one packet of pith plus. One packet of pith plus means 400 grams. 400 grams means that can be apply over the 100 kg of this coir pith. Then next 100 kg, there where 1 kg urea we are applying. Then third kg pith plus, fourth layer urea. Like you can repeat the sandwiching process till the heap reaches to a height of that 1.5 meter. That means you can lay 5 metric ton coir pith heap for composting. The basic structure is 1 metric ton of coir pith plus 2 kg pith plus plus 5 kg urea. Then you have to maintain 200% of moisture. 200% of moisture, that even a farmer can sim the very simple method to assess. That means take a small loop material of coir pith and press it. Even that one drop of water comes, then that detects the presence of sufficient moisture there. So none, otherwise you have to sprinkle some water. So, because maintenance of moisture, that is very essential in this coir pith composting. Then this coir pith composting that will take minimum 30 days. That means 1 month. Once you started the process, every day you have to monitor the heap without the disturbance of any other animals or any other things, and you have to keep the heap with a specific moisture of 200%. Then after 30 days, the high that biodegraded material you will be obtained, that is organic manure. So this is the conventional way of the production of coir pith organic manure by using this pith plus and urea. Then apart from this, the technology further we have modified by that new method, that is in situ composting, that is hillock composting. This the first that field level study we have conducted in Chertala, one coir fiber extraction units with the insertion of some PVC perforated pipes. As we know that the organism which we are employing for this composting of coir pith, that is the pith plus, it is an aerobic fungi. So by aerobic fungi, on this speeding up of the composting process can be achieved by the providing sufficient aeration. That is why the perforated PVC pipes we can that maintain on, or we can insert on this coir pith that hillock. At the first picture, the top coir pith hillock, the 2.5 meter that dia we have to make a pit where you can insert the PVC pipes, that 4-inch pipes and 2-inch pipes horizontally. You can fix it at regular intervals and keep it and cover with the coir pith, pit plus and urea and keep it for that 21 days. The process can be completed by 21 days, that is hillocomposting.